Every generation has its own inspirational people, scientists, philanthropists, entrepreneurs. Well, on this episode of The History Of, we're going to discuss the world's current richest man, Elon Musk. If you enjoyed today's video, don't forget to like and subscribe, but without further ado, let's get into it. Elon Musk was born on the 28th of June 1947 in Pretoria, South Africa. His mother, Mae Musk, was a Canadian model and dietitian, and his father was an electromechanical engineer, pilot and sailor. Elon had always had an interest in technology, and at age 10, he taught himself how to code and program. This was also the age that his parents got divorced. Elon and his brother Kimball decided to live with their father rather than their mother, and he was stated in interviews a year later that this was not a good idea. By age 12, he'd created his first piece of software, which was a video game named Blastar. He sold this game to a PC and office technology magazine. You can actually still find it and play this game today. Musk's early years were pretty difficult. Aside from the poor relationship he had with his father, he was also bullied at school. He was once hospitalised by his bullies after they threw him down a flight of stairs and beat him until he blacked out. Musk had always had the desire to move to America, and as he saw it, it was a place where someone can truly make something of themselves. That's why when he was 17, he moved to Canada to live with his mother, sister and brother and attended Queen's University in Ontario. This move was also a way for him to escape the mandatory service in the South African military he would have been required to complete if he'd stayed in his home nation. In 1992, Musk left Canada and began studying at University of Pennsylvania. He graduated with an undergraduate degree in economics and stayed on to complete a bachelor's degree in physics. During his time at university, he and one of his classmates, Adi Oresi, rented out a 10-bedroom house and turned it into a nightclub. This helped show the entrepreneurial nature Musk had, even during his time at university. The next place he went on his travels was Stanford University in California, where he wanted to pursue a PhD in energy physics. However, after only 2 days, he dropped out of Stanford, as this was around the same time as the dot-com boom, and young Elon didn't want to miss out on the new digital gold rush. His first proper business venture came in 1995, when Elon and his brother Kimball started a company called Zip2. Zip2 produced city guides and sold them to newspapers and magazines, such as the New York Times and the Chicago Tribune. This was essentially a searchable business directory, similar to the Yellow Pages, that was complete with maps and telephone directories. Musk persuaded Navtech, a provider of electronic maps, to give him free mapping software. He then wrote the code necessary to merge the business listings and maps into one software. In 1999, Zip2 was acquired by the Compaq Computer Corp, who purchased them for $307 million. The sale of Zip2 made Elon Musk $22 million just from this transaction. The money Elon and his brother made from the sale of Zip2 was used to create a new company called X.com. This company was a financial services and payments company, and about a year after its creation in March 2000, X.com merged with Confinity and would become PayPal. Musk became the CEO of the newly formed PayPal. However, this was short-lived, as after a few months, while he was on his way to Australia for a holiday, Elon was fired by the board and replaced by Peter Thiel as the CEO. Years later, Musk would joke with Fortune magazine, saying, "That's the problem with vacations." Although it's safe to say he landed on his feet, because when eBay bought PayPal in 2002 for $1.5 billion, as their biggest shareholder, Elon netted $165 million. For a lot of people, this would be more than enough to retire and live a life in comfort for the rest of your days. But Elon wasn't done just yet. In 2002, Musk created yet another company. This one was called Space Exploration Technologies, or SpaceX. He invested $100 million of the money that he made from PayPal. His goal was to drastically reduce the cost of space flights. The company first created the Falcon 1 rocket, a two-stage liquid-fueled craft designed to send small satellites into orbit. The Falcon 1 was vastly cheaper to build and operate than that of other companies such as Lockheed Martin and Boeing. One of the reasons for the cost-effectiveness of SpaceX's rockets was down to the creation of their Merlin engine. Their first launch came in 2006, which began successfully but ended quicker than expected due to a fuel leak and a fire. However, SpaceX was still considered a success and won a NASA competition for building and demonstrating spacecraft. In September 2008, SpaceX became the first privately owned company to send a liquid-fueled rocket into space. 3 months after this, they secured a NASA contract for servicing the International Space Station, which was worth more than $1 billion. In 2006, Musk began taking part in a company called Tesla Motors, which specialised in producing electric vehicles. Musk became their chairman, but took an active role in the product development of their first vehicle, the Roadster. The Roadster was released in 2008 and could travel 245 miles on a single charge, which was unheard of compared to any other electric vehicles at the time. When the financial crisis started in 2008, things were looking bleak for Tesla. So much so that Musk invested $40 million in Tesla, as well as loaning them an additional $40 million. He was later named the CEO of Tesla the same year, and in 2010, he took Tesla public, and their initial public offering raised $226 million. They were the first car company to go public since Ford in 1956. Despite being involved in both SpaceX and Tesla, Musk also wanted to get involved in yet another company. This one was called Solar City, and was founded by Elon's cousins, Lyndon and Peter Rive. Elon invested $10 million into the company, and they quickly gained success and became the largest installer of solar panels in the US. However, in 2015, Solar City lost a quarter of its value. This came after Lyndon Rive said the company was going to focus on cutting costs, as it had sunk too much money into growth and they weren't going to make cash anytime in the near future. In 2016, Solar City was purchased by Tesla for $2.6 billion, despite the company itself being in $3 billion worth of debt. By the end of 2015, SpaceX had been making waves and had made 25 launches and completed numerous missions such as resupplying the International Space Station. In 2016, the Falcon 9 made the first ocean landing of a reusable orbital rocket. Elon tells us that reusable rockets will drastically reduce the cost of space travel in the future. SpaceX's new rocket, the Falcon Heavy, was due to have its first launch in 2018 and had inside it some very special cargo. Inside was Elon's personal cherry red roadster, which was launched into space, complete with a mannequin in a spacesuit behind the wheel. After this, Musk began working on another one of his visions, Hyperloop. Hyperloop is a super high-speed train that travels in a vacuum tube and could in theory transport passengers from San Francisco to Los Angeles in just 30 minutes. This linked in quite well with yet another venture called the Boring Company. This is a plan to build a network of tunnels under and around cities to help vehicles avoid traffic and travel at high speeds. And in late 2015, he also co-founded OpenAI, which was a non-profit focused on researching artificial intelligence to ensure it doesn't destroy humanity. He later stepped down after a conflict of interest with Tesla, which was developing its own AI for self-driving vehicles. Despite having his fingers in a lot of pies already, he created Neuralink in 2017, which plans to increase the bandwidth of humans by building devices that can fit directly to the human brain. According to the Neuralink website, the initial goal of our technology will be to help people with paralysis regain independence through the control of computers and mobile devices. Our devices are designed to give people the ability to communicate more easily via text or speech synthesis, to follow their curiosity on the web, or to express their creativity through photography, art, or writing apps. Despite being one of the greatest geniuses of our lifetime, he has a tendency to get himself into trouble, especially on Twitter. In 2018, he tweeted he was considering taking Tesla private at $420 a share. The number 420 is synonymous with a lot of cannabis users. However, his shit banter backfired and he was fined $20 million by the Securities and Exchange Commission for making false and misleading statements. And in another blunder, he referred to a British diver called Vernon Unsworth as pedo guy and he had a defamation lawsuit brought against him. Musk ultimately won in court, but it still shows you he has a childish side to his personality. In another escapade in 2018, Musk appeared on the popular Joe Rogan Experience podcast, and during this interview, he smoked weed, which led to a significant drop in the Tesla share price. Despite a few scandals here and there, there's no argument that Elon Musk is one of the great visionaries of our generation. His continued work with SpaceX, Tesla, the Boring Company, Hyperloop and Neuralink is what has made him at the time of writing the richest man on earth with a net worth of $290 billion and some calling him the real-life Iron Man. Between his ambitions to colonize Mars, his passion for clean energy and his interest in new technologies, he'll certainly be an interesting person to keep your eyes on in the future. As always, thank you for watching this episode of The History Of. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and maybe just leave a little comment down below with any topics you'd like me to cover in the future. And as always, thank you for being on the right side of history.